Hello, my name is Prateek Bhatt, and this is my team Kunal, Jaswal, Kratika, khandelwal, and Ajay, and Pavas, saini. So we are from the PinE Training Academy. We are doing a 10-month course on the physical design domain, and we are here to present a project backup system which we have made using a bash script. So I would like to give you the overview that what we have done in the project. So this is the overview. Firstly, I would like to tell you that why I have opted for this project, because basically when we are working on some desktop or our system, the problem is that whenever we forget to take the backup of particular important file on which we are working. So if your system gets corrupted or some problem occurs in your system, then afterwards you are not able to recover that data. So it's a problem for us. So through this our project, whatever the files which you are working, it just you have to do that. We have already installed our project script in that system. You just have to do that. You just have to copy your folder or file from wherever you are to that particular location where we have implanted our script, and at the particular time whatever we have allocated at once, it will going to be uploaded in the G drive. So this is our main aim, and through this it is very easy for us. We don't have to take the backup every time, and because if someone gets forward to take the backup, then it's a very big problem, because many tasks we have done in our file. So this is the main advantage of our project. So I would like to give you the overview. As you know, this backup system, its content as a specific directory will move to the local backup system. Means in this, whenever we are working on a file, there will be a separate local backup system will be going to be created, as well as the RM backup. What does this local backup do? Local backup means local backup will be on your system itself. Whenever you are updating your files, so several local backup will be there. But RM backup is the backup which is going to be uploaded in your drive, and it is once only. So this is the process, and we have divided our whole project into four short blocks which I will going to explain you briefly. So let's come to the terminal, and I would like to explain. So this is our project. Firstly, if anyone going to use this, we have to install the G drive on that system, and particularly doing the whole work in automation, it is not possible, because if you are going to provide the username, then the security purpose is also there. So I would like to see that we have fetched the data of installation and access. So this is a short script which we have made in one go, and what we have done, we have whatever the command is there to install the G drive, we have write in one script, and just you have to do that. You have to source this file, and when you will going to source the file, it will going to ask you for some information. I will let you know. See this like this, it will going to become, because by clicking on this link, you can go to the authentication of your drive, whatever the it is, and then you have to type the verification code, then it will going to be processed further, because this is a purpose of the security. So we cannot do the whole the process automation, and after doing this, you have to we have written a script G drive access, because after installing you have to access it also. So by this our short script, you can access the G drive in your system, and when you have done this, you can see this in your system that what is occurring. See like this, it will going to be seen. It means that it has been connected and it is now can be accessible by your system. You can access a G drive in your system. So this is, so I will start to show you the demo how it works. Firstly, if we have made a help file for our whole project info, if anyone wants to know that which command or which search is how it is working, so they can be see through this, they can be see through this particular file. So we have made a project info file. We can do the source project info. When you will going to source, it will ask for, do you want more information related to project? Yes, we want. So we can type yes. So what we have done, we have divided help searches, different searches, help file, output log and output data. In the help file, you will going to get all the details about the particular searches which you are using in the G drive. Different whatever the searches you are using in G drive and we are using in our project, it can be there in the help file and we can get the details in the from the help file. So we will type help file. Let's see what is going to be see what I am seeing. All the information that firstly you have to the install your G drive, then this project itself create a local backup. Yes, that purpose, that thing I will going to explain you later. First see this, and this is our different functions that what our G drive function can do. It can do many things, but what the things we have taken in our project, I would like to give you that much only, because it's a very vast and there are many different advantages of G drive there, but we are going to explain that only these six functions. So first is this, the list files. So for list file, we have there is a search list. You will just type list. See, for the list, there are different searches. The whatever the you can use, minus C, minus M. There are various searches you can use. The options, there are various you can use it. And if you want to see different information other than the list file, we can see list is what were the list do whenever you want to see that whatever the particular directory or files in your G drive, you can see with the help of list. You can just write G drive and list, so it will going to list all the files and directories in your terminal from your drive, that whatever is in your drive. And with the help of upload, when you write G drive upload, that it will going to upload your files in the G drive. And for the particular directory, you have to recursively upload the files in the directory. We can see the different options also in the upload, whatever the different options are there. See, there are many options are there that if you want to explore more, then here it's the information for this. So I would like to process further. And download option what means what? Means once you have uploaded the file in the drive, and if you want to fetch that information or that files again, then you can use the download function. Then what does this download do? This download will going to download that particular file from the G drive to your system. So it's a very easy for us to get access that file which we have lost with that. And file info means file info, when you want to get the information of a particular file, then you will going to use the file info. Because if we have made a file and made a file in the G drive, and we want to get the information of that particular file, then with the help of file info, we can get the information. And if you want to make a directory in the G drive, then mkdir, if you write G drive mkdir, then it means that it will going to create the directory in the G drive. We can see the different options in the mkdir C. There are many different options in the G drive. And delete. If you don't want to use that file in your G drive and you want to delete that particular file, you can use this delete. You can see delete to delete the files. G drive delete. It will going to delete the files from your drive. Delete. And there are different options also of the G drive. You can use it. And now we will like to see that what is output log and output date. So output is basically, let me show you with the example. See, what does this do? This is basically, it will going to show you that your uploaded file is in which format and of what it is going to be uploaded and at what particular time. It is a whole path. Basically, if you are going to upload a file in format, file name, data, time. So first is our file name, whatever, and that at what date we have uploaded and at what time it uploaded. So this is the information of that. And if we want to get the information of every local backup and RM backup, that at what time it will going to be uploaded, then for that you can go to the output date. See, this is what I want to say. Output date. Through this, you get the whole information about your script. Basically, this I have run earlier, so it is showing that information. You have to, that our script started at this time. See, our script started at this time. And local backup is created. It will going to also show you that your local backup has been created, and after created, at what time it will going to created. All the information is there. And if your local backup is already exiting there, then it will also show you that your local backup is exiting there, and the whole and this information is there. So I would like to give you the demo. What are the different blocks? Block one is this. The blocks checks the presence of local backup folder. So suppose we have created a local backup. So our block, this will going to check the local backup. If local backup is not there in the specified location, then the created otherwise move to the another block. It means that basically we want to upload the local backup itself, so we have to check that if the already local backup is exiting, so we don't have to create it, we have to work it on that only. So we can see the timing of creation also, as I have just shown you with the help of log file. And this is our block one. And now move to the block two. This blocks checks the presence of remote backup. Remote backup folder means that the backup folder which is in your drive. It will also going to see the location that that your RM backup is going to be created at the drive or not. If not, then it will going to be created and your files which have been backup, it is going to be saved in that only. And of that timing also we can see with the help of log file. And then after that, we are going to create a local backup, because after the local backup is created at the specified location, we know that a working directory, basically a working, we have made a working dir in our project script, in our project directory. At that particular directory only you have to copy your file. At that particular working dir you have to copy your file, and afterwards it will going to fetch the information from working dir to the RM backup automatically at the time which we have allocated. So a working directory is which is created, it is created with the, it is a replica will be going to be created with the specified date and time, and it will going to move to the local backup directory as well as the RM backup. And what is the advantage of this? Because suppose if your internet is not working, so it will not going to be uploaded in the G drive, we know. So for that, for what, so what is a reason for that? So if it is not going to be uploaded, then where it is going? So at that time, the whatever the files will going to be uploaded at that time and it is not going to be uploaded due to the net issue, then that file will going to be saved in the local backup. And afterwards, when the net comes at and the time we have allocated, then it will going to be uploaded in the drive. This is and our block 4 is the remote backup, which is nothing, just a main use of the crontab. And what does this crontab do? This is just a basically a simple command, and it's going to be run in the background. Basically, it will going to schedule all your tasks repeatedly, and whatever the time it will going to be you have allocated, it will going to be schedule your task at the background at that particular time only. So we can see this through an example. Let's see. First, I will like to show you G drive list, that what is in the my list. See, there is no RM backup and there is no local backup. Okay, so I will give you the live demo that how this my file is going to be uploaded in the G drive. You can see here also. No RM backup is there. Now we will use the crontab NSE. I would like to explain what is crontab minus E. Crontab minus E means it will going to edit your path, that whatever you are going to be assigned. And there are different crontab minus L and crontab minus R is also there. L is going to list that whatever you have going to edit it. We can see with the help of that command. And minus R is that whatever the crontab installation has been done by you, it can remove. So you will type crontab minus E, and what we have to tap. Firstly, there is a minute, because you have to give minute. It is a 24 hours format follow. So you will have to give them firstly minute, and then hour, and then date of month. Okay, then date of month, and then month of year, and then day of week. So for you showing the demo, I have just taken the minute and hour, and the rest I have put star, so it will not going to take care of that. And afterwards I have given a path where is my final project. This is my script, and where it is my script. So I have given the whole path, so you can see that the time is 2:01 a.m. So I will give this is a minute. Okay, 2:02 a.m. and with the help of Control X I will save. See, I have saved. Okay, and now it is 2:02, so we will wait for some time. Okay, and this you can see this here it is shown that crontab installing new crontab. It means that it is showing you that your crontab has been installed, and with the help of L you can see that whatever the update you have done. And then what are the different directory has been came in your directory? Just see the local backup, which is not earlier. Local backup has been created, an RM backup, and this extra working directory, which is particular time at what time your file has been uploaded. And now the main thing which we are going to see, G drive list. And this is one of the most important thing, that the rate limit exceeded, because whenever we are trying to upload too many files to the drive, the API request has been declined. So this rate limit exceed come from, so this thing we cannot improve, because this is a thing from the Google only, because there is a limitation, some limitation is there. So we have to do again. See, when we have done again G drive list, and now you can see the difference, the RM backup and working drive. It has been created. earlier when I have done, there is no RM backup. This means our file has been uploaded successfully in the drive. You can see live also through this. See, this is what I am saying. RM backup has been uploaded already, and this is a working directory which is in the RM backup. Now if you're going to copy any file in the working directory, then it will all automatically going to be uploaded in the RM backup. And this is our local. I would like to show you that what is in the local backup. See, that working directory is going to be saved in the local backup as well. And this working directory is saved as in the RM backup also. So our file has been successfully uploaded in the drive. Now I would like to show you my code, my script that what I have done. This is the first, you can see this is what I have done. This is my code which has been divided into four basic blocks. Firstly, I have made, firstly that is a, this is the starting for the G drive access and install purpose. And then this is to check if the local backup folder exists or not. If not, then create it. So I have fetched all the files or directories from our path where we are, and I have put in that particular file. Then we are going to check and doing all this, and if it is not there, then it will going to be create, and if it is there, then it will going to proceed further and then creating local backup. Then if this condition is satisfied, then this we are going to change the name of the working DR with the help of MV, because it will going to create the different name with the date and the time at what time we are going to be uploaded. And with the help of log file, we are creating we are fetching the information of the time as well, that at what time we are uploading the files in the drive. And one thing more we have done. Suppose the more than 7 times more than 7 days it has been done and your files has been uploaded. So the working directory which has been created in your directory, so it is the maximum limit we have put is 7. After 7 days it will going to delete all your files. So there is a limit of 7 days. At that time you have to download your files, and this to check if the backup folder exists in the drive or not. If not, then create it. This is the same as that of local backup, but this we have to check in the drive, and of that also we can see the log file, means the at what time it will going to be uploaded and at what time we have created. And at that last, what we are doing at the local creating local drive backup, which is with the help of crontab, because crontab function is very important in our script, because without the crontab it is quite difficult or maybe impossible to do, because crontab is going to work your script in the background and it will going to schedule all your tasks at a particular time. So we can see that what we have to do, we have to just, if a particular man has to get his backup, so firstly he has to install his G drive in his system, and then he just have to copy his file to this project folder and then this particular working directory. This is the main working directory. He can copy his file in this working directory, and the rest, whatever the time we are going to allocate it with the help of crontab, the allocation of time with the crontab, it just a one time only, because I have done now, I have to show you, because if you have to give the time at once only, and suppose I have given at 10 p.m. then at 10 p.m. your files will going to be uploaded. You don't have to worry about taking backup every time. And so I would like to come. And what is the features of this? As you can see, there it is a very simple and the crispy coding. It is easy to understand for the new users also, because they can understand very early and easy for them also. We don't have to take backup every time in our hard disk, as we have already discussed with that. We can upload the files at any time and date with the help of Chrome. Yeah, this is the main advantage for this, for the purpose we are using this project. And we can see at what time our local backup and RM backup is created with the help of log file. We can see this, and we can have Google backup as many times as we want to help in the content. Yes, but there we can see many times at the content. As you all seen that we cannot do whole thing automated because security purpose. First of all, we will not going to do the whole task, because you have to give you some credentials, because it is private and everyone can access it, so it is pretty much insecure. So for that, we have just given a scenario, and you have to go through that process to put all your information, legal information there, and then you can access it. And it is very useful. We can implement it also and further, and we can improve it also. And the problem is just the rate limit exceeded, which is an API problem. We can also see later on that what is that, and we can improve it. So this is from our side, and this is all about from our side. Thank you so much.